Okay, so the second video is more about character creation, play locations, and kind of how the new season's gonna run. Now, don't take anything I say in this video word for word, because until you see it in print, you know, you wanna be sure that it actually works that way. But you can assume that this is just a preview of what we're expecting, and then you know, we'll see that actually pans out as it is. But the basics are first, character creation. So character creation in the new season will be usual. We'll be having, you know, the five basic species. Orc and Uruk-hai will be available, but not really anything else. There is a completely new backstory chart that I'm using, that I wrote all of the backstories for. I've got about half of them all, like I'm putting it in the first part of the season, and then I'm gonna add to it over the season, so that as you go through and make new characters through the season, there are backstories that didn't exist before and they can keep coming in. And but these are gonna be done differently than we have in the past. Instead of rolling on a chart, which everybody can see, they're gonna be cut out, and then you take them, pull them out of a bag, and then that's your backstory. This will also limit how many are even in the bag, so that if certain people can't, like a whole ton of people can't have the same backstory exactly, there wouldn't be enough in the bag. This also gives you a printout of it so you can read it. And also, these backstories have never been used before, so they're all brand new. There was a lot there. There's tons and tons and tons of content just in that little piece. So that changes. We've been through 153 years. That also isn't reflected in these backstories and how they function, and that they reflect the way the world works in a little different way. So that's the first thing. The second thing is mods are changing. After the 153 years, mods shift as well. So we're going to see a change in mods that's two parts. One is that the main part of your mod should be the flaw part, meaning that's the part that you think about what the flaw is going to be. It's probably the more powerful or just a strong part of your mod, and the part that might in fact impact combat situations and things. The flaw should be the main thing you focus on. The ability it gives you is actually has to be something that you can only use out of combat. It's mostly supposed to be something to give your character more depth or more range, but not any combat abilities, nothing that actually increases your ability to win a battle or survive a battle or anything like that. All the abilities that you get from your mod are supposed to be abilities that you use in an out of combat situation, or are just more flavor, or change the look or feel of your character and make them more unique, but not more powerful. The flaws, on the other hand, they will probably trigger in combat. You can have flaws that have effects that trigger when you're in a certain combat situation, but they are flaws, and they need to literally be flaws. They can't just be an ability hiding as a flaw, or an ability in red text, as we often say. All right, so that's character creation. The other thing that's really important this season, that's different from last season, is that we aren't starting characters at really high level like we did last season, because we were just, last season we did the summer and we went immediately into the season and we just continued. So this season is more like the traditional setup, where we start all level one and we're, you know, slowly advancing in the story. And because of that, the play locations are kind of insulated. It means that the places that you're starting to play are not in really high intensity and really high risk sort of situations. They're places that your character could kind of develop and have some fun and do some things that are more silly or interesting, and, you know, as they level up, and not be like really stressed that, oh my gosh, if I don't win this battle, you know, this place fall. It's not like that. Definitely not for the first, you know, fall season and into the winter. It should be more of a relaxed feeling, in that there are definitely threats, but those threats are not, you know, all consuming and, you know, end of the world like threats. They're threats that are for a level one, two, or three level character to deal with, which are more personal and things that they have to kind of solve at that level. So that's for our start locations. Now, every 3 months or so, you know, whenever a new season comes around, like winter and then spring, I may shift the location, but I'm probably not going to shift it in a way where we completely uproot everybody and they all just are suddenly somewhere else for some reason. That would be unlikely. It's more likely that they will be moved sort of within the country to a different region or part of that country that is a little bit more at their scale or caliber. The only time when we might see a big shift is if something happens in the plot that really pushes the story in a certain direction, and then characters would be sent there and they're high enough level, or characters start to come out of retirement and they're very high level characters, and then things might move. But I don't see that happening for a while. Okay, so that's play locations in terms of how insulated and character creation and leveling. We will try to keep the leveling to, a nice low pace. We're going to try to make sure that there's a cap to the amount of levels you can get in 1 month, and that it doesn't move too rapidly so that characters are left far behind. We want to make sure that it feels even. We'll discuss that at the leagues. I'm not going to quote anything specific here, but my guess is that probably you're going to end up with being able to get the usual, which is one session for every event that you're doing, plus an additional session if you're doing more than one set, and then we'll add that up and see what that equals out to. We've been debating whether we want leveling to be harder to do, or whether we want to give out less sessions. And it's sounding like less sessions is actually winning, rather than changing the actual, structure of leveling. We'd like it just to be that we maybe are more paced with our sessions that we hand out, and maybe break up those sessions into smaller amounts. So don't quote me on any of that. That's something we'll discuss in the leagues and decide. So play locations. So the play locations that I'm planning anyway, subject to change, but it's looking like tomorrow's event, or Wednesday's in Palo Alto, will be in Pinnacle on Hostor. And it looks like Thursday's event will be in Spireguard in Aeon. And it looks like Friday's event will be in the Keep of Trolldun, which is in Blackspire. The whole country, part of that country, run by trolls. And then it looks like the weekend leagues will be up in Menenos, in Ilionos. And then for the Tuesday league, that one I won't say yet, because it doesn't start for a while, and they need to get planning. I need to see my group first and see what would be best for them. Okay, when it comes to making characters, you cannot make them yet. You gotta make them at the event, because like I said, there's a new whole system for it. But it should go really fast, because you can just take your card and mods also should be very easy to approve given how simple they are. So we should be able to get right into game. All right, that's it. And looking forward to a really cool season.